5, they're more likely to be independent and living at home after 12 months. So we wanted to see if the same thing applied. So how did we go about this? First of all, we used SNAP and we used Mervyn, and we were able to get data such as when a patient had come into the hospital, whether they were alive at 90 days, where their discharge was to, and those sorts of things. We could then use Mervyn to take plasma levels, the sodium, the potassium, the urea, and the glucose within 24 hours of their admission. And from that, we used a standard formula to calculate the plasma osmolality. It was the same formula that was used in the previous study. So we had 310 admissions in 2.5 years. Of those, 170 were excluded. That was for various reasons, like a glucose not being ordered in the first 24 hours, potassium being penalised, that was really, really common. And we ended up with 140 sets of patient data. With those 140 sets, we used below 296 as the normal plasma osmolality, above 296 as raised, and then we used a delay to ASU at 4 hours because that's the common target. So before we look at the results, I thought I'd mention that it was a retrospective study, it comes with limitations. A number of our patients were sent straight to ITU, so they never actually made it to the acute stroke unit, which meant that they were excluded from the study. And naturally, these patients often had worse outcomes because they went to ITU. And so there's a bit of a bias away from mortality, we imagine. There's also all of the comorbidities that can add to stroke risk, and that can bias data. And we also used, we didn't include the comorbidities. And we also used a calculated plasma osmolality. But studies show that there's a slight difference between calculated and measured plasma osmolality, maybe a couple of milliosmoles each way. But that's enough to shift your patients, especially in the bell curve, which is obviously what it is when it's variations of normal. And you can never have too many patients. So what were our results? First of all, we did see that plasma osmolality is associated with a raised 90-day mortality rate.